Trip Trap Bar, the Bronx, early evening. So someone had...
This whole thing is complete bullshit, and always has been. I mean, what's his job, really?
To keep shit from reaching the Woodlands. Jack, I don't know where they are.
You're a bar. You're supposed to have darts around.
And I normally do, but who knows where the fuck they went to after...
Is that Jack Horner?
Come on, Jack, Holly. I need entertainment. This'll do.
I'll entertain you. You can relax.
Okay, I know. Just relax. I'm not here to start anything.
Okay.
Miss White, I heard you had kind of a strange morning.
It's been kind of a strange morning for everyone, I think.
Every time I see this guy, he seems to lose weight. It's amazing. It really is. He loses weight and yet somehow keeps all the muscle.
Jack.
Wolfie, my dear, how are you? Because, you know, we were just talking about you. All of us. At the bar, here. About you.
Just need to talk to... Never mind.
I'm dying to hear about the body that came out of the East River this morning. It was a fable, right? Oh, everyone knows.
Tweedledee was just here.
Was he?
He said it looked like Snow White.
Not
sure
Tweedledum?
It wasn't Tweedledum?
Well, no, but he seemed pretty sure.
Crane.
Sorry.
Tweedledee said you arrested him for no earthly reason. Kept him locked in the cellar all fucking night. He said you tortured him.
Good impression.
I don't know, that seems like a breach of your legislative duties.
I did not.
Believe me, come on. You can't be so dumb as
Jack,
to...
Jack, find the off button, now.
What is it with you two? You and Gran are all, let's get a posse together when there's no one around. But as soon as the big bad wolf walks in, your tails go between your legs.
I did not torture
Jack
him.
Jack got your nerve. What happened?
I blew smoke in his face.
I'm tired is what happened.
Tired of what?
Of trouble, Jack. I'm sick and tired of trouble. I don't want any more. So just stop revving his motor or wait outside or fuck the hell off. I don't care which.
Both of you.
Listen.
Bigby, look. Two fables are
it's
dead.
Not listening.
Shit. Gren's sister.
It's Holly's talking. Sister.
Holly's sister has been missing for what? A few days now? And we haven't heard word one about it from anyone.
Whatever.
Actually, have there been any updates? On my sister.
Be gentle.
I don't know how to say this to you, Holly. The woman we found in the river.
Who was it?
You know who it was.
Instructed to use the perfume. By who?
Boy, I sure walked into that one.
If you say one more fucking thing, just one more thing.
What Jack is that? Jack who jumped over the candlestick?
God fucking damn it! Of course, the dear princess, Snow fucking White, is all safe and sound.
Where
were you when we reported this weeks ago, huh? Where are you when we ever fucking need you? You'd give 1 ounce of a shit about her, about any of us. She might have been saved. She might have been cared for. She might have...
Fight. I'm sorry, Holly.
I'm sorry, Holly. I'm sorry we found your sister this way, and I wish this had ended up better.
Holly,
get the fuck out of my bar.
I just want.
It should have been you. It should have been you, and it wasn't.
Huh. Imagine someone telling you that, though.
We recovered this from her personal effects. I thought you might like to have it.
Was that their crest? Family crest?
I didn't know she still had this. The copper was from a dwarf mine. It's very rare. And very old.
That was decent of you.
Gren.
Yeah?
Take off for a bit, would you?
Are you sure?
Sounds sure to me. Jumping Jack Flash. Use a gas, gas, gas. New entry.
I don't know.
Sorry. I didn't realize she was about to start talking. Jack. Jack. It is Jack Horner. Harmless trickster. Jack is always up to something, but he's not nearly as smart as he thinks he is. His plans to get rich quick often backfire, but his confidence never wavers. He thinks he's the most important person in Fabletown, but everyone knows him as a mostly harmless smartass. Yeah. I could see how he would think he's the most important person in town, but really not.
Not that much about our life. Honestly, we didn't talk often.
Still, you cared about her.
She was lost here, in the city. She just got swept away by it.
Why was she glamored?
Do you have any idea why she'd be glamored as Snow White?
What? Oh, God. I'm sorry. That was probably about... She was hooking. To pay down debt. It ate me up to see her that way. Eventually, the only people she owed were at her work. You know, that shithole club, the Puddin' and Pie.
Puddin' and Pie?
The owner, Georgie, with all his fucking fees. It's a crock of shit. That's how they kept her under their thumb, really.
Guess we're going there next.
Holly, it's okay. If it's too much...
Georgie Porgy Puddin' Pie.
Georgie.
Sorry, guys.
What do you know about him?
We can just go talk to him.
Mm-hmm.
We've got a lead. Maybe we can take it from here.
Anything else you can tell us?
Anything else you can tell us?
I don't think so. Like I said, we didn't talk much.
That's all right. You've been more than helpful.
Is she... Where is she?
She's at the business office. She's taken care of.
I'm gonna have to go down there and get her. Fuck.
Please, we can handle the funeral arrangements.
No. It's a kind of... It's a formality with trolls. We burn our dead by sunrise or... I don't know.
I'll check with Crane.
Shit will fuck your soul up.
I'll check with the deputy mayor about that. He'd want to be kept in the loop.
This is really important to me.
Look, why don't you come down with me to the business office and... We'll see what we can do.
Promise to check with Crane. Alright, now I gotta do it.
That club?
I'll go down there now. See what I can find out from the owner.
You were good with her. I'm impressed. Really, thanks. It just made everything easier.
Thanks. I got another. I got two more. Lily, a strange sister. Lily and her sister Holly grew up in the homelands together, but had a falling out shortly after moving to the mundane world. Aimless and increasingly destitute, Lily turned to prostitution, and now she's the second victim in an ongoing murder investigation. These people had no idea all this time they were actually doing it with a troll. But any reason she specifically changed herself to look like Snow White? And who put the perfume saying, use this? Yeah, it doesn't exactly add up. I mean, I could see making herself look like Snow White to, you know, just, I guess maybe as a fetish thing for some clients. Maybe she had a client who wanted her to... Oh, someone who has the hots for Snow White. would give her that perfume, tell her to use it, and to make herself look like Snow White. Oh. Not necessarily the person who killed her, though. That's just an unfortunate series of events. Ah, here's Snow White. Killed her. But nope, it was Lily all this time. Someone else had her glamored. Who would, want that, right? Ichabod Crane, maybe? Troll Cross. Lily's brooch. A Troll Cross is an amulet made of iron that was foolishly thought to protect the wearer from trolls. Lily acquired hers while wandering through the wilderness searching for something to eat. She came across a human, but before she could devour him, he held the Troll Cross out and shouted, "Back! Back, you troll!" After enjoying her tasty snack, Lily plucked the cross from the dead man's hands. After the exodus, she wore the Troll Cross constantly as a reminder of better days. Oh, yeah, Troll Cross didn't work. From I guess we're heading to the pudding pie. Georgie Porgie pudding pie. Pudding pie. The Bronx evening. She looks really young.
Oh, Sheriff, what a nice surprise. I'm not sure I've seen you here before. You're always welcome, of course.
I thought she was hooking.
Or both.
Looking for someone.
I'm looking for someone.
Finding you someone is our specialty, but the club's closed.
Not quite what I meant.
That's too bad. I guess you'd better talk to Georgie?
Yep.
You're in luck. He's here. Come on.
That's what I was looking for. I thought she was hooking, but I guess, yeah, she...
I should warn you that Georgie does not like to be bothered when he's working.
She works
And
here.
He's in kind of a mood right now. I mean, more so than usual.
Is he alone?
Is he, alone in there?
He's working with one of the dancers, but don't worry about that. Discretion is our guarantee.
Hmm.
Welcome to the Pudding and Pie, where we cater to the diverse tastes of the Fable community. Your pleasure is our pleasure. Your desires are our desires.
Somehow
Your
I doubt
imagination
that.
Is the menu, and discretion is our guarantee.
Did you know Lily?
Did you know Lily? She worked here?
My lips are sealed. You'd better ask Georgie.
Hmm.
What do you think you're doing? You look like you're trying to take a shit. Who's gonna want that? No one's gonna want that.
Nice guy.
Fucking dozy bitch.
Nice guy. Seems like a real prince.
You do have a sense of humor. That's good. Good luck.
You're supposed to turn the clients on. That's your job. You want them to feel happy. You want them to think you feel happy.
Right, so just so I'm not interrupting him, I'm gonna have to cut out parts because there's actually nudity there and I can't really have that in a YouTube video, sorry. So, yeah, he's not a very nice guy. So, when she's on screen, hopefully it's not while he's talking. I'll have to blur that out.
You want them to forget about your shoulders and those fucking narrow hips? You...
Hi.
Oh, it's you. We're closed. For fuck's sake. You, stay right there. We're not finished.
You, Georgie? Oh, I didn't say anything.
Well, come on. I'm a busy man.
What do you want, then? You here for a little taste? Tell you what, come back after midnight, maybe. I can hook you up. Or, knowing you, she's probably not quite your style. You'd prefer someone who can take a bit of a beating. Tell me, do you prefer a stationary target, or one that will put up a fight? I can arrange whatever you like.
Not here for that. Price.
I'm not here for that.
Ooh, I'm not here for that. You just stopped in for the chips, then.
Wrong
Jesus,
again.
Bigby, you're so corny.
I love it, though.
No, seriously, I love it.
He's like, give me strength.
Okay, all right, Sheriff. Just fucking with you. Look, I know why you're here.
Do you? Oh, I didn't even realize this was a choice. Yeah, do you?
Are you sure?
Listen, Sheriff. Around here, we can't afford to wait for you and your swanky pals to take an interest. We have to look out for each other. When shit happens, I hear about it. Especially if it concerns my livelihood.
In that case, I assume you knew Lily was glamoured.
Of course she was, you daft git. She was a troll.
No. I mean glamoured to look like another fable.
Yeah? Well, so what?
Who gives a toss? People get up to all kinds of things when nobody's watching. It's their own business.
I think you're behind this.
You got her a black market glamour as part of some twisted sex fantasy.
Ooh, black market, is it? How exciting.
This is exactly what I would expect from a thug like you. Storm in, throw around a bunch of accusations, try to scare people. But you've got fuck all to back it up.
And we're all just meant to jump any time the wolf shows his teeth. It used to be something, you know.
Nothing to back it up? Well, what the fuck is this, then?
Get that out of my face.
I found it on Lily's body, and it's definitely a back alley job. Where did she get it?
You've got this all wrong. If Lily was doing a special glamour, it wasn't for me. For fuck's sake, I want that kind of heat.
Who was she doing it for, then?
She had clients, Bigby. Maybe one of them was into it. A lot of fucked up people in Fabletown.
Like who?
Try looking in the mirror. Anyway, now what to do with me?
I'm not a suspect.
Go on, then!
I'm gonna turn it off.
You're gonna hit me? Go ahead! That's what you want to do, right? That's what you came here for, right?
I'll shut this place down.
Right. Tell me what I want to know, or I'll shut this whole place down.
Oh. Nice going.
Oh, no, fuck!
That was you.
Bastard fucking shit. You proud of yourself, mate? Proud of your little mess? Fuck's sake. Fuck up, Hans.
You're the clumsy one. Was that Hansel? As in Hansel and Gretel? Hans, is it?
Hold on a minute. Hans, is it?
Hans just cleans up and provides a little muscle when we need it. He's not gonna know anything about the girls and their clients or any of that. No one knows. Don't you get it? It's by design. Discretion is our guarantee, right? And the way we guarantee that is that no one knows anything they don't have to know. Including me. I cover my eyes and take my cut. End of story.
Why not look it up?
What's that?
Isn't there a little book with all the stuff about the girls and all that written in
You're
it?
You're a fucking moron.
Ha ha.
Show me.
There is no book.
Yeah, there
and
is.
As for you, Hans, we need to work on your communication skills.
Crowd control?
And have a fairly good idea where to start. Hey, that's my personal property.
Not anymore. Tell me about the book.
Sure, go ahead. Do what comes naturally.
Tell me about the book.
You haven't got the slightest clue about anything.
So clue me in.
Hey, now.
Let's break the cigarette machine. Hey.
You shouldn't have messed with that.
Georgie, remember.
Don't even think about it.
Just tell me where it is.
Look, Georgie, Why don't you just tell me where the book is?
Can we please not go round and round about this? There's no book. End of story.
Do not touch that. You hear me? That's nothing to do with you.
Wreck it. Ooh,
well,
what we got here?
What's this? Looks like a floor safe.
I wouldn't know. It was here when we moved in. I don't have a key to it.
There's a book in
Sheriff,
there.
Will you come on? Fuck's sake, I've got to open up in a few hours.
Give me the book. I'm warning him in between bashing stuff.
Give it to me.
You're a big bad bastard. We get it. Everyone's guilty. We fucking get it.
Jesus. You're killing me. I'm begging you. I'll pay you.
Smash the sign.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
Come on, Nate. Leave it. There's nothing there for you.
I'll destroy this place.
You might want to stand back.
All right.
You better not forget that. Don't have the key. Inside is a non-existent book.
Bloody come on, then.
That's supposed to be his spinal column?
Fucking trash my business over this bullshit. Protector of Fabletown, my ass. What a load of crap.
You're the one who made things difficult.
Once again, don't get your hopes up. There's nothing in here that'll tell you anything. But it's a kick to the balls for me and my club, so we can be happy about that.
I see a book. Oh. It's a little book.
Here. This is Lily's last entry. So tell me, Georgie, who's this Mr. Smith?
Oh, dear. I'm afraid it might be a fake name, Bigby.
Is that Fred Rogers?
Secrecy is sort of how this all works. Even Ance knows that.
Mr. Smith, Mr.
What's
Jones.
What's 207? Room number?
I don't fucking know. Millimeters, maybe?
Don't bullshit me, Georgie. This is your book. Your girls.
I'm not their fucking secretary. I give them a stage. I give them music. I provide an erotic venue to attract and retain clients. But let's be clear on something. The girls make the arrangements with their clients, not me. The girls. They're the ones with the Mr. Smiths and Joneses and Mr. X types. Whatever happens outside the club, that's on them. I log the business, take my cut, and I'm out. Now, I've had quite enough of you and your bullying. Excuse me while I call your superiors to make a complaint.
What was that, Ichabod? Who's calling? So who writes the entries? The girls?
Hello. Business office.
Look
yeah,
at
that's right.
I was looking at a wall, though. Anything else in here?
I want to talk to the deputy mayor.
Small stack of bills. What's that other
58.
Book?
58.
Faith's money that I gave her.
I don't give a rat's ass about that. Just fuck off and fetch him for me, all right?
That's the money he gave Faith. Exactly $58. Well, we got our money back.
No, I don't want to.
I'll leave the rest. Back out. Just taking back money back that Faith that I gave to Faith.
Fine, I'll hold.
Excuse me. Pack of cigarettes. I think I messed around enough. Literally just looking at it. Alright, so what's her name went in there? Unless that's another girl. Well, they said it was just the two of them in there.
What's that?
Cigarette machine again. Anything else I can look at?
Porgy. It's Georgie Porgy.
Pudding pie. I'm still holding the money. Put it in your pocket, Bigby.
Road hard. I wouldn't be calling if it wasn't important, would I?
Put up wet. Sunny lights. Adonis, feel the thunder. Morgana? What, Le Fay? No.
Well, his fucking subordinates down here harassing me, that's what.
Lady Morgana from Merlin? It's a Morgan Le Fay, isn't it?
Subordinate.
Subordinate. Oh, they were little cubbies. Cubby, cubby. This Faith's cubby. A makeup case and a jewelry box. Busted open.
Lock's been busted open.
Yeah. That looks busted open too, the latch.
Broken open. But there isn't even a lock.
Hmm. A note.
Faith, thanks for covering for me tonight. Let's talk before you go over to the apartment. Lily.
Really?
Looks like they both saw one of Lily's clients.
Too bad they're both dead, so they can't tell me. Cosmetics. And some change.
Lipstick, lip gloss, compact, glitter. Faith.
You didn't take it all. Whose cubby is this? Lily's.
Excuse me.
I heard you out there.
He's got clothes on now.
I don't remember ever seeing you here before.
I'm here now.
I'm here now.
Yes.
There's a lost cat pixel again.
You're trying to place me.
Place you.
They used to call me the Little Mermaid.
You're kidding. That's Ariel?
Once upon a time. Does that help?
What are you doing here?
What are you doing here?
Sad times falling ahead.
Same as anyone. It's a Ariel. Place where I am. Where else am I supposed to be?
What happened to the red hair?
My name is Nerissa.
Well, Nerissa, oh. I've got some questions.
Of course you do. I don't have answers. You'll have to find those yourself.
Not Ariel? Lily last night?
Did you see Lily last night? You know, where she went or who she was with?
We can't talk about work.
This is a murder case.
I mean can't. These lips are sealed. Discretion is our guarantee.
Oh, jeez.
It's how things work here.
I don't give a damn.
By design.
I don't give a damn about your guarantee. I need you to cooperate.
Nerissa, remember that.
This is what I need to know about. Lily's last entry. Who's Mr. Smith? Where's room 207? I have to know.
These lips... Sheriff Wolf, would you like to make an appointment with me?
Then, can you tell me? What are you suggesting?
What exactly are you suggesting?
We could make all the usual arrangements. The usual place.
She's telling... Oh!
I see. What would I need to do?
She's telling me without actually telling me.